We had a fire party patrol down our street in the last war. So when this war started, we thought we'd have another. We got plenty of men. They were all eager and willing to join up. I think we had about 60 men at first, but then as the younger men were called up, our numbers decreased, and we only got about 50 now in our patrol. We've got them all ages. We had one old chap of nearly 70. Of course, we didn't expect him to go climbing ladders, but he fetched water for us, and so on. As our numbers grew, we thought we'd better organise ourselves properly. So we got together and decided to approach the local authority. The controller and the council did us proud. They supplied us with stirrup pumps, long-handled shovels and buckets. We have got a room in a bombed house. It was in a dilapidated condition, but the chaps made it comfortable in their spare time, with electric light and fire. Well, everything's pretty smoothly, but of course, questions were always cropping up, difficulties, differences of opinion and so on. So we fixed up a committee and had regular meetings. We chose 7 men out of the patrol and took complaints and suggestions. We used to meet every Sunday morning or afternoon, adopted suggestions if they were good, and dealt with complaints wherever we could. Well, that made things easy for me. I was the leader, like, and if a chap came to me with a grouse or a suggestion, I just said, "You bring it up in the committee on Sunday." Then the first firebomb fell. Every man rushed to the spot and there was the most awful confusion. There was water all over the place, everybody trying to do the same thing at once. And we were all fawning about and getting in each other's way. I thought, this won't do. We've got to organise this part of it also. So we divided up our patrol into groups of 3. Stirrup pump teams, like. One man on the nozzle, another pumping, another fetching water. Now each group had its own bit of patrol to look after. Now, our street is about 200 yards long, and we do both sides of it. A lot of the houses are empty, but we've got sandbags and water buckets outside them, and we know how to get into any house at any time. When new ideas came along, like the home guard, we thought we'd lose a lot of our men, but we didn't. They took on the other jobs and stuck to us as well. Some of the men do home guard duty or fire watching for their own firms, and then come on our patrol. That shows what you can do if you like. Then, when this compulsory act came in, some of our chaps thought, now all we've done will be upset. But that act hasn't made a bit of difference to us. We go on just the same as we did before, because we went on the right line from the start. In fact, we feel very proud that we were already organised, and we know that our time and trouble wasn't wasted.